لا 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 لا. Holy Hitchhikers rijdt door het meest bediscussieerde stukje land op aarde. Op en rond de route 60 in Israël. De zwaarst bewaakte weg ter wereld. Hier bij de bushaltes pikken we Joodse lifters op om hen mee te nemen naar hun dorpen in Palestijns gebied.
Bye bye.
Hier zijn ze dagelijks doelwit van aanslagen. Maar ondanks de terreur gaat het leven door. Vandaag is het 5 mei. De dag waarop hier in Israël en door Joden wereldwijd de slachtoffers van de Holocaust worden herdacht. Vandaag zijn de Joden 2 minuten stil. Ook op de snelweg waar wij rijden staan er vooral Joodse bestuurders stil. Op deze voor Joden beladen dag ontmoeten we Joshua en Rinat, Uri, Eitan en Emar en Yehuda. Allemaal herdenken ze vandaag de slachtoffers en staan ze stil bij de bescherming die ze als Joodse natie, omgeven door Arabische landen, nog steeds hard nodig hebben. Vandaag rijden we de route 60 op en neer van Gush Etzion naar Jeruzalem. En van Gush Etzion naar Migdal Oz. En van Maon naar Kiryat Arba. Bij het zwaar bewaakte knooppunt Gush Etzion stappen Joshua Nussbaum en zijn collega Rinat Cohen in voor een lift naar het centrum van Jeruzalem.
Jerusalem?
Me?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Let's go. So why are you going to Jerusalem?
I work there with kids from like troubled homes.
Wow. And what kind of things do you do?
I do like play therapy. Like I play with dolls and stuff with them, and then during that they open up and they talk. Stuff they're going through. I believe that everybody, except if they have brain damage, can be 100% whole. Meaning everyone that has even psychiatric illnesses that in the book it says is incurable, I believe with prayer and with tremendous, relentless work and prayer, maybe it'll take 10 years, 20 years, they can get to emotional health and happiness 100% and only grow through the experience. That's what I believe, so I try to help people. So I like helping the people that the doctors told them that they will always be emotionally sick.
And what about you?
Well, I'm a student to Tanakh, to Bible.
What's the most important thing you've learned so far?
I think I learned the first things, that God did not leave anybody. If you think it's the end of the world, no, don't think it. God with you.
Rinat spreekt uit ervaring. 5 jaar geleden zijn haar ouders gescheiden. Een moeilijke tijd. Ik vraag haar of ze toen de hulp van God ervaarde.
Yeah, of course. I think just him.
Just him?
No, not just, but I have a lot of friends that help me, and my family, my sisters, very help me. But a lot of time, how much I angry to God, he was missing me all the time. Even I don't see that, this, I know it. I need to believe it and see this, you know what I mean? And I think if not I was a believe man, this divorce was destroy me. But because I believe in God, I think it hold me. You know, it hold me and it take me up.
Was there ever a moment that you experienced something of Hashem being close to you? I'm so curious about that, you know, how you experience your God.
Yeah, I have a moment that I feel that God with me, hug me, you know.
Hug you?
Yeah. And I think in the dark in my life, in the most dark, I feel it the most strong.
And what does that feel like? Being hugged by...
It's rather good, you know, you need to... How am I? 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 How am I?
You have to bring it down into our experience, you,
yeah,
into our world.
To bring down to our world. You not stay like, hey, I wish God and all this. I think you need to take it and do with this thing. I try in my national service to give this experience to the girls that I was with him. You know, they was little, they was 16 and I was little too, but more big from them. So you need to, you know, God give you a present, you need to continue with this present and give to our people.
Rinat and Joshua rijden verder richting het centrum van Jeruzalem. Iets verder buiten de stad pikten we eerder die dag Yehuda op. Ook weer bij het kruispunt Gush Etzion aan de gevaarlijke route 60 die dwars door de Westbank loopt. Hier worden de bushaltes bewaakt door militairen, want regelmatig zijn Joden hier doelwit van aanslagen. Op deze bijzondere dag dat de Joden de Holocaust herdenken, vertelt Yehuda ons hoe zijn oma in de Tweede Wereldoorlog Nederland weet te ontvluchten.
Hallo. Where do you need to go?
Migdalos. She was born in Switzerland. She got to Holland to learn how to be a farmer in a place called Enschede. You know Enschede?
Yes, Enschede. So, yeah. You know
it. So she lived there, and then she wanted to get to Israel, but. Then the English still was here, and who that want to get here was need a certificate.
Yehuda's oma heeft een geboortebewijs nodig, maar reizen door Nazi-Duitsland is voor haar als Joodse veel te gevaarlijk. Uiteindelijk lukt het om via het certificaat in handen te krijgen. En daardoor kan ze vluchten naar Israël. Maar veel familie blijft achter.
Yeah, a lot of her family is killed.
A lot of her family is killed?
Is killed in the... Yes, in the Germany.
But what kind of effect does this have on you? Knowing that a part of your family is not alive anymore.
All that you do, you know that there is people that not here, that there was a time and it's not so far that 6 million of us was killed. And it just, it's make you all the time think what we can do for it will not happen again, never. And this is a thing that I think every Jewish one thinks about it all the time.
Het is voor niet-Joden nauwelijks voor te stellen, maar bijna elke familie hier in Israël heeft mensen verloren in de Tweede Wereldoorlog. Er zijn diepe wonden geslagen. Sommige families werden compleet uitgemoord. En van anderen overleefde slechts een enkeling. In Israël voelen ze zich hier nu relatief veilig, maar de geschiedenis heeft hen geleerd dat uiteindelijk geen enkel volk te vertrouwen is. Antisemitisme is overal en waar dat toe kan leiden wordt op een dag als vandaag extra gevoeld. Ik vraag de lifters of ze denken dat een holocaust nog een keer kan gebeuren, nu de vijandigheid tegenover Israël wereldwijd steeds groter lijkt te worden.
Well, today we're remembering a lot of holy souls that went to the other world. But we're not angry, we want to remember and take the lessons and move on. And life is about being happy, not about living in pain, but we need to remember what happened so we can grow from it.
Did this affect your family, for instance?
The Holocaust?
Yeah.
Personally? No, we had no one, except my uncle was in the American army and he died in it, but we didn't have any. But the Jewish people are all one family and the whole world is one family, so you know, you feel it. Everyone's one family.
But these days, how do you think back of that time?
I think this day we feel how the Jewish people are strong.
Now we're here in Israel and we gotta just be really, really happy and know that also there, that was the darkness. God was there too. And
how was he there? I think this is the main question for so many people. Where was God in this?
It was God. God did it.
God did it?
Yeah, it was only God. How could something like that happen without God? Only God could do something like that. But he's so great. We can't ask questions. Sometimes you can ask questions, but when something's so big like that, you just say, if you want to know why, then you start hurting. But if you just, there's a higher intelligence than us, we have no way of understanding it, and we just know that he loves us and he was there. We don't know his ways. His ways are bigger than us. So.
But how can you believe or say God is love and things like this happen? I'm trying to understand that.
It's a very good question, because you can understand it. It's something above the mind. Certain things, when we know, when you know, you find a wife, or you have a baby, or you get whatever you have, and you know things are going nice for you, then that's when you understand it, and that's important. And then there's a lot of things in life you don't understand.
This is a planet of God, and this is a believed Jewish. Even we don't understand what they do to us and bad things happen, we continue to believe that it's good for us, and we need to learn and to get up from these things and to try to continue in our life in happily, and we hope everything take us to Geula. Mashiach, and we're waiting.
De Joden in Israël kijken uit naar de komst van de Messias. Dat horen we hier bijna iedere dag. Want dan zullen de volken in harmonie samenleven en zal er vrede zijn. Het verlangen naar die vrede is groot. Want al kregen ze na de Tweede Wereldoorlog een eigen land, werden ze een zelfstandige natie. Vrede is er allerminst. De haat van de omliggende landen voor de Joden is groot. Iran dreigt onverminderd met de totale vernietiging van het land en steunt terroristen van Hamas en Hezbollah. Hamas vecht al jarenlang om Israël van de kaart te vegen. En die wens leeft bij heel veel Palestijnen. Regelmatig rijden ze hier met auto's in op onschuldige mensen. Willekeurig worden Joden op straat met messen gestoken. Het is niet verwonderlijk dat Israël zwaar inzet op de beveiliging van haar burgers. Zeker met de geschiedenis in het achterhoofd. Want meer dan enig ander volk weten de Joden, het kwaad valt niet te onderschatten. is Rinat niet bang voor een nieuwe holocaust.
Again, because the Geula come, and when Geula come, not have Shoah to Jewish people. And I think in our world now, it's not can be to happen again. Everybody do everything that it's not happened again. It was terrible. All the world think this, most. But I don't know. I don't think like this.
What about you?
I don't think it's ever gonna happen again. I think once, you know, that's something, once God like brings you, we were in the diaspora for 2,000 years. He brought us back here. So, you know, you gotta believe when God redeems you, He redeems you. And you have to trust it, you know, when something, God loves, He's only good, so the punishment is the abnormal. The suffering is not the norm, so it should surprise someone tremendously that something not good happens to them, because God loves them, and then if it happens, you know that it's only for the good. So if He brought us back to Israel, why would He bring us back to hurt us? He only brought us back to do us good.
Op deze dag waarin herdenken centraal staat, kijken de Joden ook naar de toekomst. Naar wat nodig is om hun land te beschermen. Alle jongens en meisjes moeten verplicht een paar jaar het leger in. Vanaf Jeruzalem stappen Ori, Eitan en Eimar in. Hun dienst vandaag zit erop. We brengen ze terug naar huis en ze vertellen dat op deze weg kort geleden hun dierbare rabbi en zijn zoon werden geliquideerd.
Ago, near Otniel, my rabbi, murder, Rav Yaakov Eitman, and his son Netanel. They murder by our base.
Their families doing Shabbat and eat together and they murder.
You heard it for the first time. What did you think?
I scream and cry which was very very hard to us, my family, and they ask all the time why it's happened.
How we ask how a man can do this terrible. This is not. I don't understand. I don't.
So.
But we trust on the God, and we know that in the Torah say that all what the God do. Everything is good, and maybe we don't understand why, but always we trust. It's very hard, but we trust on Him always.
But this kind of hatred, that's also what you will be facing when you are in the army, right? You might have to kill somebody too.
Don't have a chance. I need to. How do I say it again? I need to save
my country.
My country and my family and my wife and my children. I don't have a chance, I don't have a choice. If I not need to go to the army, I not go. This is not the army, this is not a normal situation. But because the Arabs want to kill you and want your country, you need to protect the country, you need to save.
Onze lifter Yehuda weet ook hoe het is om zijn land te beschermen. Na verschillende Palestijnse aanvallen breekt er in de Gazastrook een oorlog uit. Yehuda dient dan bij een artillerieeenheid en is onderdeel van de bemanning op een tank.
And one night was a very very hard battle. When it was a battle in Sajaiya. Is in Gaza, and there was 13 soldiers killed the artillery, but in Gaza in this battle, yes.
But were there your friends or your companions or?
My friends was there. They didn't kill, but they was there, and they entered to a place that they didn't know very well. Very difficult place to go, and a lot of soldiers of Hamas, and it was a very hard battle. Yes.
But what is it like for you to really shoot? I mean, you fired.
I want to kill all the bad people there inside, but maybe there is a good people there in Gaza, and I don't want to do something to them. That was very hard too. I remember this because.
So on your conscience.
What?
It was hard on your conscience.
Yes. Yes, we talk about this, all the friends. But you don't want what to do. In artillery, you don't see what happened, where your fire is falling, because it's kilometers. So you don't really know what you did. The commander is telling you, but you don't see it. And you don't know. That's hard, because.
But it's quite a dilemma. You have to protect yourself, but on the other hand, you feel like you don't want to kill innocent
because,
people.
No, because it's hard. It's a hard feeling, but it's not a struggle.
So we're here.
We zijn aangekomen bij de kibbutz waar we Yehuda afzetten.
Thank you.
Israëlische soldaten mogen alleen geweld gebruiken als zij of andere Joden worden aangevallen. Ze mogen alleen reageren en niet zelf de aanval openen. De druk waaronder de vaak jonge militairen moeten werken is hoog. Hier bij de bushalte zijn ze de hele dag in opperste staat van paraatheid. Want in iedere auto schuilt mogelijk gevaar. De drie militairen in onze auto doen hun dienstplicht, maar ze zijn bang voor de emotionele gevolgen van een eventuele verdedigingsactie. Ze zijn bang dat hen dat voorgoed zal veranderen.
If you go to the army, you yes. might come into a situation that you have to kill an Arab.
Of course, we think about it. I'm afraid that it can destroy all what I build in my nefesh.
heart, in my heart.
In my heart. From this I'm afraid, but I don't afraid to kill Arabs if I need. Because they want to kill us, and we need to protect the country.
In your heart, you are afraid that something will change in your personality.
We need to turn left.
What are you afraid that will change?
It's very hard to explain that, because it's something in the Jews, we call it midot. We work on us to be good men. It's very hard to explain that. All the Torah, it's our life. It's very hard to explain that.
You're afraid that you won't be a good person anymore.
Yeah, kind of.
We zitten de jongens af bij de zwaar bewaakte bushalte bij Kiryat Arba. Vanaf hier gaan zij verder het settlement in, op weg naar hun families die hier wonen. Ook al worden onze lifters regelmatig bedreigd, toch zouden ze nergens anders willen wonen. Ze zien de oprichting van de staat Israël als een wonder van God. Tot 70 jaar geleden had niemand kunnen bedenken dat de Joden ooit weer een natie zouden vormen. Met een eigen plek waar ze als volk zich eindelijk thuis voelen.
You said it's part of a bigger plan.
Yeah.
What bigger plan?
He knows. He knows that plan, to bring everything to perfection, to bring everything to good.
You mentioned the Messiah, this Messiah.
To bring the Messiah, to bring the world to peace.
Messiah, will
you
be here?
Yeah, of course. You need to come all the minute. Maybe 2 minutes. Maybe now. We like this. I try to wait like this. Every minute he need to come.
There'll be peace, people will love each other, God will be present everywhere. People, it says in Isaiah, the world will be filled with knowledge like water fills the sea. Knowledge of God. So
you're smiling.
We're looking forward. But we don't know when, only God knows when, right?
Joshua en Rinat komen aan op de plek van bestemming in het centrum van Jeruzalem. Om met hun families de Shoah te herdenken. Zonder bitterheid, maar vol vertrouwen in een goede God. Het is bijzonder om deze dag hier mee te maken. Want ieder jaar herdenken we ook in Nederland de 6 miljoen Joden die omkwamen in Europa. Vandaag ben ik er getuige van dat het kwaad niet het laatste woord heeft. Europa erkende de staat Israël, maar keert het steeds meer de rug toe. En dat terwijl ze juist nu aan alle kanten wordt bedreigd door de omringende islamitische volken. Van harte hoop ik dat het antisemitisme dat wereldwijd weer de kop opsteekt, stopt. Dat genocide op de Joden voor goed verleden tijd is.
La 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 la